Pokemon is one of the most popular media franchises in the world, and among their most impactful products is their card game. With over 15,000 unique cards across 106 sets, there is a lot to collect. But behind all the cool and interesting art, there is an expansive card game that has a very popular competitive scene. I am part of that scene. As of today, Pokemon Card 151 has been released globally, which is a set comprised of all the original 151 Pokemon from the Kanto region. And in an attempt to learn the game and the balancing philosophy, I decided to get together three professional Pokemon TCG players in order to judge a custom set that I made using this website called PokeCard Maker in order to make my very own custom 151 set for the Hoenn region instead. They will be rating all the Pokemon in a tier list as I go and will give me some constructive criticisms as we progress through the set of 195 total cards. God, I wasted my life. With that out of the way, let's get started with...
Alright, what's up guys? My name is Larry. I'm a Pokemon player from the Chicago area, and I'm a pretty avid TCG player. I'm really trying to aim for my invite this season. Got 70 points so far, so I'm on that journey. 70 out of 600.
Let's go.
I've been very excited to go over this set because honestly, Generation 3 is one of my favorite generations. I grew up in loving Flygon and Ludicolo and a bunch of other cool dudes from Hoenn, so it's been a pleasure to review this set, and I've been in the hobby for about 17 years now, so I'd say I've got a pretty good background in the game and knowledge of the Pokemon, so it's been a pleasure to go over the set.
And it's a pleasure to have you, Larry, but now it's time to go and review the trainer cards. Now, normally trainer cards come last in a set, but I decided that it would be best to introduce them first in order to give the judges an idea of how the Pokemon function in relation to the new trainer cards. Okay, we'll skip all the way to 136. Okay, so Ability Capsule, Draw Power, basically it's fleet-footed, but can be attached to any Pokemon. So, as long as they're in the active, they may draw a card.
Yeah, I mean, you can't really go wrong with that, right? There's no real downside, and for decks that don't really have any real draw engine, it's definitely something that they would consider. I would say this would probably be like a 7 out of 10, kind of middle-of-the-road kind of card.
That doesn't seem like too horrible. I don't know if it's worth taking up a deck slot. I'd say that's like a solid 4.
It's a 10 out of 10 card. It's just free draw.
Okay, that's pretty good. Next up, the Acrobike is returning as a tool card rather than an item. So, regardless of the Pokemon, it has 2 less retreat, and once during your turn at the Pokemon, this card is attached to is on the bench, you may switch it into the active spot.
Why did you give Acrobike an errata?
I don't, because I wanted it to be a tool card. I felt like a Pokemon riding the bike would have been more sense.
But regardless, that's 2 less retreat costs. You literally give a Pokemon the Russian ability. Do you have an idea how what you've done?
This card's actually insanely broken in terms of its strength. Cards like this that have given like two retreat costs less are always used. Just the flexibility of that, like this card in something like Lost Box would be insanely broken. It's got to be like a 9 out of 10 or 10 out of 10 card in terms of strength.
It's an S tier. It's just Bloodstone Russian for any Pokemon with 2 retreat costs or less.
Now, one thing you're going to notice throughout this entire video is that I think that the initial text of a card isn't good enough, and think that I need to add more to it in order to make the card good. One such example is with Lysias Performance. The first part of the card is pretty solid. It allows you to search your deck and discard pile for up to 2 stadiums and place them into your hand. Seeing as the format doesn't currently have a stadium search or recovery, you'd think that it would be a pretty solid card. But I didn't. So I instead gave it an effect where if you place down either stadium, you prevent it from being replaced for a full 2 turns!
Hey, this makes Path disgusting.
And for those of you who don't know, Path to the Peak basically states that you can't play the game.
Yeah, it's a 10 out of 10 because it's so just Path.
Another card that I made too busted is Steven's Strength, which allows you to attach 2 energy cards from your discard pile to your Pokemon in any way you'd like. Energy acceleration is a big thing, because you can only attach 1 per turn. It also has the added effect of having your Pokemon deal more damage with their attacks, as well as take less damage during your opponent's next turn, making them effectively unkillable in the right situations.
Yeah, this card would be disgustingly broken and poorly designed in terms of a like balance standpoint. This card would be like 11 out of 10.
It's another case of Yu-Gi-Oh! Syndrome, where you keep adding shit because you think it's bad.
But aside from that, a lot of the cards that I made were actually pretty balanced. And some other cards I made might not have even seen play in the current meta. But one card that I definitely made insanely overpowered is Wally's Charisma. Now, the original effect with Wally was that you could search your deck for a card that evolves from one of your Pokemon to evolve it, even if they came into play during this turn or if it was your first turn. Now, what if we were to take that card and put it on steroids? That's basically what Wally's charisma is, times 10.
This is, once again, disgustingly broken. Just imagine this in the Charizard deck.
And now that the trainer cards have fully been unveiled, it is time to finally get to the Pokemon. Now, one thing I want to introduce within this set is abilities that carry through evolution. Reason being that it adds an extra layer to deck building, as well as an extra layer of competition in order to help out other cards that might not be considered good without those extra abilities.
The ability is nice, and the fact that it carries through evolution is nice.
And it's not just Treecko that gets this ability. Pokemon like Torchic, Mudkip, Surskit, Aeron, and so many others get this ability. But what's the point of having abilities that carry through evolution without the actual Pokemon that they evolve into being good? That's where EX cards come into play. These are cards with a very high number of HP and very strong attacks at the expense of you having to give up two prize cards whenever one is knocked out. This has a sense of high risk, high reward into the game because you can either choose the regular card and play it safe or play the stronger, more valuable card in the sense that if it gets knocked out, you lose a lot more. And this set is not shy of them in the slightest, with there being a total of 16 to collect. And here you go, Flygon EX. I know you like Flygon, nice. So
give I do. It's probably like a 9 out of 10 overall.
Let's go, we did it. Got Flygon a good card.
Finally.
And a lot of the cards that I made with these EXs were actually pretty good. A lot of them were very competitively viable, but none that really stood out as game-breaking or absolutely busted. In fact, the Jirachi of this set, which I thought was going to be a very heavily played card because of how good I thought it was, ended up being mediocre at best.
It's not bad, it's just like, cards like this, like, they were never too great, especially when they're tied to multi-prizers, because while you're getting a card out of your deck, it's like you're losing a two-prizer. It's like Revenge Blast, it's like, at the very most, you can only lose three EXs naturally. I don't know, it's like your strategy would evolve too much around getting EXs into the discard, and that's kind of counterintuitive. So I would give Jirachi like a 6 out of 10.
Meanwhile, Ghostfish, the other judge, had a completely different view of the product.
This might actually fix the main problem of prize cards' existence.
And it's really interesting seeing how different their views are on the set as a whole. I mean, if you take a look at their tier lists, you can see a very drastic difference. Mainly because Ghostfish made an entire extra tier based off of how busted I made some of the cards. And looking back, yeah, I do realize I made a couple of the cards a little bit too busted. One such example being Zigzagoon, which is a card that can search out any one of your tools cards and attach it to one of your Pokemon, meaning that you can literally get Forest Seal Stone turn one. And because Forest Seal Stone allows you to search for any card in your deck, you can literally get any card in your deck turn one. Which, yeah, in retrospect, probably should have been made a little less busted, but it is what it is. And I mean, hey, it's Zigzagoon, so are we really complaining? He's the boy. But anyways, once we were done, it was time for the judges to give me their final thoughts on the product. What are your final thoughts? What would you give it out of 10?
Oh, I mean, like, The set's great, of course. Like I said, I've got a special connection to the set, and it's just cool to see you put in the effort to make it. So, I mean, I've got a special connection to Hoenn. It's cool to see you put, you know, show some creativity, and so yeah, it's good stuff, man. It's hard to design a set in general, so it's like I would never even want to do it. So, I mean, props for doing it, man.
Thank you.
I mean, of course, it's a 10 out of 10 for effort.
Thank you.
And balance wise, of course, there's some issues I pointed out, but like it's hard for somebody to know about all the potential balance issues. That's why, like, you know, Pokemon company members, they get paid the big bucks to do stuff like that.
Yeah, obviously. I appreciate you so much coming out and helping me out with this.
Yeah,
I rate this set a 6 out of 10 for balance.
Better than I thought, honestly.
It's not balanced at all. Nah, you know what? This is a 3 out of 10. This is a really unbalanced set.
What?
This is an insanely unbalanced set. Like, if this came into the format, I'd quit Pokemon. I would never come back to the game.